In this video, I am going to explain why restriction of liver can affect so many other joints and structure. You know what? When your liver is restricted, most likely your right shoulder is affected. Actually, I uploaded about this mechanics for other videos, so please check that out. So I am going to do quick review from that video first. Why liver and right shoulder? Key structure is nervous tissues. This nerve is phrenic nerve. Phrenic nerve is from C3 through C5. Okay, this number is very important. C3 through C5. But how come right shoulder? Phrenic nerve is inside part of abdomen and of course cervical spines. It looks like there are no connection to right shoulder. There is connection. You need to know one more structure, that is nervous tissue from cervical spine. This is brachial plexus. Brachial plexus that emerges from C5 through T1. There's common number, right? That is C5. This is common number. That is why when liver is restricted, this tension continues to phrenic nerve, then via C5, this tension can affect brachial plexus. That is why right shoulder is affected from liver. I want to talk about a little bit more details about right shoulder. What kind of tissues would be affected? Again, when liver is affected, right shoulder is affected, but how? What kind of tissue is that? Of course, shoulder joint can be affected. So when you have shoulder pain, you can't move your shoulder, you have frozen shoulder, and you go to hospital, you took MRI, you took x-ray, but doctor says there's no problem. The tendon is not torn, joint is fine, your labrum is fine, but you got a pain. How? That can be diagnosed as shoulder periarthritis. Shoulder periarthritis. I want you to be careful. I am not the doctor, so I can't give prescription and I cannot diagnose. But this is tendency. When there's no damage around shoulder joint, but you can't raise and you have pain, maybe you will be told you have shoulder periarthritis. That's most likely from liver. Why most likely? Isn't it always? It's not. It can be from associated structure. Maybe brachial plexus gets tension, like because of a whiplash, or shoulder injury, or head trauma. There can be various reasons that your shoulder have tension. And liver is one of reason that you have shoulder periarthritis. Does it make sense? Again, I am not medical doctor, so I can't diagnose and I cannot prescribe. But this is very important thing. So this is why shoulder joint has restriction, because of liver. Anything else? Maybe shoulder muscles can be affected. Shoulder muscles via, of course, phrenic nerve and brachial plexus. What kind of shoulder muscles? Any muscles like rotator cuff, pec major, or other shoulder girdle muscles such as pec minor. Many muscles related to upper extremities can be affected by liver. If you follow the pathway of brachial plexus, that also can affect biceps brachii, elbow muscles, wrist muscles, and finger muscles. But in my opinion, symptoms tend to show up around shoulder, this area, because this is literally close to phrenic nerve and liver. Of course, you might have elbow restriction, but I think it is slightly rare compared to shoulder restriction. Does it make sense? This is why liver is very important. One more thing about upper body. Do you remember where is phrenic nerve from? It's from C3 through C5. So when liver is restricted, then this tension can go to C3 through 5 via phrenic nerve. And tendency is right side cervical spine can be affected more than left. Why? Because literally, liver is on right side. Right phrenic nerve has relationship with liver. Thus, right cervical spines tend to get restriction. Does it make sense? Oh my gosh, so many important relationship with liver. For next part, I am going to explain core restriction and liver. So when liver is restricted, core can be restricted. How? Because liver is physically close to core, such as ribcage, diaphragm, core muscles, right? When you get this function on liver, ribcage can be restricted, like a lower ribcage, such as rib 7 through 10, about this area, right? Physically, there is liver. From continuation of ribcage, thoracic spine can be affected. Why T7 through T10? Because of rib 7 through rib 10. Rib is from thoracic spines. Makes sense. And what is above liver? Diaphragm. Diaphragm has multiple connection with core muscles such as psoas, transverse abdominis, transverse. That is why liver can make restriction for core, both for thorax and abdomen. Very important, huh? Then at last, I am going to explain connection with head. Okay, this is a little bit advanced connection. This is liver. This is profile view. Again, what is above liver? There is diaphragm. What is above diaphragm? There are lungs and heart. Lungs and heart. You see this connection? There is a myofascial connection inside part of thorax and abdomen. Then where is this fascia going? Does it stop here? No, it doesn't. There is continuation. There is continuation all the way up to base of head. So it can reach all the way up to head via fascia of internal organ. Again, when your liver gets dysfunction, that can pull myofascia this way, that can pull fascia of thorax, that can pull fascia of neck and head. It is common that restriction of internal organ can create headache. I think this is kind of rare, but theoretically it is possible. Okay? And you can say same thing for other organs such as stomach or intestine. Why? Because they are internal organs. You can follow the fascia of internal organ to anywhere. So this connection is not only for liver. You can say same thing for stomach, intestine, lungs, and heart, any other organs. Okay? In this video, I explained why liver restriction can affect other parts of body. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.